I think it's time we got explicit about the physical processes that lead to genetic variability and the physical passing on of our genes. Now, if you want to have your own biological children, there's a pretty important event that must precede the presence of children. Instead of thinking of you having your own children, let's just think about you, right? Here I am, pretty happy, 30 years old. But where did I come from? About 30 years ago, I was in my mother's womb, developing as an embryo and then fetus. But where did I come from before that? About 9 months before I was born, I was conceived, meaning that the sex cells from my parents, the sperm, fertilized the egg, and I received my very first cell with a full genome, half from mom, half from dad. And of course, about 30 minutes to one full day before conception, there was a pretty important physical interaction my biological mother and biological father had to go through, the act of sexual intercourse. For me to be here today, standing here, teaching this course to you, all three of these previous events must have happened. My parents must have found each other and exchanged sex cells. They must have had a successful fertilization of these sex cells. And I must have had a successful development in utero, or growing in my mother's womb. Now, while I owe a lot to my mom and dad for bringing me into this world, I really owe their sex cells, or what we call gametes. Gametes are either sperm or egg, sperm in male, eggs in females. And germ cells make gametes. Germ cells are the precursors to the sex cells. And in this case, the word germ doesn't mean germ-like bacteria, it means germ-like germination. Like a flower. The cells that make our gametes are called germ cells because they are the seeds for our germination. So understanding how germ cells make gametes is a really critical component to understanding which alleles you're going to get from which parent. Let's talk a little bit more about how that process of cell division is going to occur.